Hi there, YouTube viewers. Welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, and you'll notice the change in scenery. I stopped the last video at the stable, and I'm starting this one at Fort Hateno here. Between the two videos, I decided to come on over here in order to spare you the tedium of watching me gallop through the wilderness. Now, while I'm here, I have two goals that I hope to accomplish. First, obviously, I want to solve the mystery of that shrine that that Dr. Fellow was talking about. And Dr. Callop telling me about this. When a dark light resides in the cursed statue's eyes, pierce his gaze to purge the seal from the shrine. Now, I feel like this must be something that happens at the spot with all of those little statues that the doctor led us to a few videos ago. You might remember that. We spent some time there, tried to find out, you know, what the puzzle was, but nothing came up. So, really all I can think of is go back there and just wait for something to happen, which sounds incredibly boring, but I just don't have any other ideas. And hopefully there will be some kind of cursed statue, and at some point, and when it shows up, I'll just shoot it through the eyes with an arrow. That's my plan. Now, in the meantime, though, there's something here on the wall I want to investigate. This pinwheel here. That wooden clacking sound is exactly the same sound that the Koroks make. You all agree with me on that, don't you? So, I just feel like this has to be connected to the Koroks somehow. Question is, how exactly? Oh, you know what? I just had an idea. Unfortunately, I can't do it. I'll bet if I had a Korok leaf, which I don't, but if I did, then I could hit that, hit this thing with a puff of wind, and that might make something happen. So, the way to find a Korok leaf would be to chop down a tree. Okay. So, where would be a good tree? How about this one? Didn't drop a leaf. Well, darn it. At least I got some wood out of it. Okay. Still no coral, please. This is being unexpected annoyance. Oh, after I arrived, I did a little bit of exploration. And I found some more ore rocks up there. Up on the cliff top there. And at the top of this pillar here is a treasure chest that has an iron sledgehammer. I already have an iron sledgehammer, and anyway, my weapon inventory is... What the? That looked like a miniature version of that huge rock monster that I bumped into when I first arrived in Hyrule. Aha! Korok leaf, finally. And of course, I can't carry it. Because my inventory is full. Alright, let's see. Oh, wrong. Okay. Let's see, what should I drop? I'm gonna drop the torch. But I'm not gonna drop it over here, because then I'll forget to go back to it. I know I will. I'm going to drop it here next to Cody. That way I'll find it again. There we go. Cody, guard my torch. Do a good job. I'm counting on you. Now, I'm gonna take this leaf. Are those rocks bombable? Uh-oh. What the? What did I just do? I'll use this. Oop. Yeah, the Boko spear is badly damaged, but I don't care. Bombable rock. Oh. Okay, seriously, things just keep distracting me. But I have to check it out. I just have to. Treasure chests. Fabulous. Another emblazoned shield, which I can't carry because my shield inventory is full. And an opal, which I can carry because for some reason you have infinite inventory for stuff like this. Excellent. Okay, fortunately that didn't take very long. Now, let me see. Maybe climbing up would be faster than going the long way. Okay, so, with a Korok leaf. Now that I have my Korok leaf, don't go too far, Link. Now that I have my Korok leaf, this thing is spinning. It was facing the other way before. What the heck? Okay, never mind. Okay. Ugh. Do I have to shoot those things? Is that what this is about? Let's use a weaker bow. Not a good shot. Okay, come on. Is that it? too early or too late. I knew it had something to do with the Kuroks. Wasted a lot of arrows to try to figure that out, though. Okay, well, since you're a Kurok, enjoy your lease. I wonder if I can retrieve any of the arrows I shot. And what happened to my torch? Cody, I trusted you. Well, never mind. Okay. Stick with this one for now. Okay. So yeah, unfortunately I just don't have any better ideas about solving this shrine puzzle that Dr. Callop was going on about. Just go back to the place where all those statues are. The place that kind of resembles a graveyard. And then just wait until something happens, basically. I simply cannot think of anything else. Still beeping at me. Cody, stop. Put an apple here. Will something pop up? Okay, that I was on the right track, but putting it there is turning out to be a bit of a challenge. Okay, this is not what I expected. But hey, it worked. You know, I remember a setup like this back in Kakariko Village with a bunch of these statues where one of them was missing an apple. Next time I'm there, I should try the same thing. Hey, wait a second. Where are you off in such a hurry? I try not to set foot outside my hut when night falls and monsters begin to roam this area. Okay, that's actually pretty sensible. Just because I'm a trained archaeologist doesn't mean I have any skill with a blade. Quite the opposite, in fact. Is that a kind of sly Indiana Jones reference? Well, I'll let you get to it then. Yeah, really nothing to do except just hang around and hope something happens. Cody can take care of himself. I am getting up out of reach. Wait a second, what's glittering over there? More acorns? Whatever. Good vantage point, and if any, I don't know, stall children, or whatever the plural of the name is, pops up out of the ground, I should be out of reach of most of them. Nothing to do but wait. What was that? I thought I heard something. Sounded like kind of a grinding sound. Oh well. So, while we're waiting, I've been thinking lately, which is never a good sign in a game like this. But yeah, I've been thinking lately. Over the past couple of videos, I have killed some Octoroks using a shield bash. And the way I did that was when they shot their rocks at me, I shield bashed their rocks back at them. You know, just letting their rocks hit my shield didn't accomplish anything. But shield bashing their rocks at just the right moment caused their rocks to just fly right back at him and smack him square in the face, and they died. So that seems to imply that any kind of ranged weapon, maybe not any ranged weapon, but certain ranged weapons can be reflected back at their source. And that makes me think about those massive guardians. Those old wrecked guardians, some of them have been coming back to life, and when they come back to life, unless I find cover quickly, they shoot lasers at me. What if I try reflecting their lasers back at them with a shield bash? It sounds ridiculous, but and it works on Octoroks, and they, you know, resemble octopedal monsters, do these big guardians. Maybe the same principle will apply. It's worth a try, but I'll tell you one thing right now. If I'm going to practice doing that, I intend to save scum. Because a failure would kill me in one shot. Oh, wait a second. Oh, look at that. There's a statue down there with what looks like a purple glow in its eye. See that right ahead? Yeah. Oh dear. Hey, good work, Cody. Oh man, my bokosphere spear. Come back here. Ow. Wait, is there another one? No, there isn't. Okay. Good or bad? Oh, this is good. Yes. Yes, this is good. I did it. Yes, I did. Okay, Shrine Detector, you can stop beeping at me now. I mean, I know it's here. The Kam Urag Shrine. Of course we have to do it now. This will sure make it easier to come back to Fort Hateno. You know, if I ever feel like coming back in the future for some reason. Not a coincidence that all of these locations have shrines nearby. You know, there's a shrine right next to Kakariko Village, and there's a shrine right next to the horse stable at Dueling Peaks, and there's a shrine right next to Hateno Village. To you who sets foot in this shrine, I am Kam Urag. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I offer this trial. Trial of Passage? That's a pretty generic name. Okay, this is just too perfect. I have to give this a shot. Close, but not quite. That was interesting, the way it jumped there. Okay, well, this obviously isn't working. Let's take a closer look. Something tells me I'm gonna have to use stasis to make this work. And or maybe magnesis? Let's start with magnesis to lift those spiky balls out of the way. To the abyss with you! This is looking like a stasis puzzle. Laser beams? Oh my goodness, laser beams. Okay, well, wait a second, how did this thing get up here? You know what? You want to be in my way? You pay the consequences. Wait a second. I'm thinking maybe it was serving to stop up the works there. But again, that would just require stasis, really. Oh. Now I just wait to be able to use this thing as a platform. Like so. Definitely want to get that treasure chest right there. I figure it has to be probably a key. One of these treasure chests must be a key. Because that seems to be a new function that shrines have started using. Spear, eh? Another soldier's spear. Okay. So what do I want to stop up next? Let me see here. Okay. So I was wrong about that treasure chest being a key. Not quite perfect, but good enough. Yeah, nothing too difficult. Of course, these shrines never are all that difficult. They're basically just small tests of skills, so... I got the two treasure chests, and I made it up here. So I'm finished. I still think it's an interesting way they phrase that. The promise of a true hero. Which, you know... is an understated way of saying you're not a true hero, at least yet. Okay, so I've accomplished both of the things that I came here to do. The question now is, where should I go? This being an open world game, it's pretty much up to me. I'm gonna. Alrighty. That worked. Another shrine. Okay, that could be what was causing my confusion earlier. With the way I... Because the shrine detector only beeps when you're heading towards a shrine you haven't visited yet. So there must be another shrine up there somewhere. But how to get there? Let's see, where would be a good way up? Because it's gotta be around here somewhere. Well, okay, that's actually a much smaller area. It's probably more like, around here somewhere. Well, that's not really important right now. The real question is, all these quests I've got. Now, it's saying that I have to do this, basically. The bit about the captured memories, that's one of the main quests. It's on my main quest list. But just wandering around trying to do this, focusing on this, that seems kind of dumb. What I really should do, I think, is focus on this. If I make that the main quest that I'm worrying about now, you know, that leaves me four locations that I have to go to. And four new areas to visit, four new towers to get the map from. And as I'm wandering around doing all of that, I'm sure to stumble across at least a few more of these. So, that's what I'll do. My overall goal for now will be to take care of this. And hopefully, in that process, I'll find more of these locations. And this... This is the only shrine quest I've gotten so far. I guess there's going to be more. Side quests? Meh. None of these really interest me right now. Okay, so... First things first. Get out of here. I'm gonna go back towards Hateno Village. I remember reading a signpost there along the way that talked about two of those things. Okay, let's get a different weapon. Start using these. Okay, that's not doing any damage. Not good, not good. Okay. So that I have my shield available to me. try blowing it up. Okay. Come at me, bro. Right across that. I pushed the wrong button and it almost ran out of time. Come on. There we go. Yeah, those resemble smaller versions of that big one that I met when I first came down into Hyrule. And this is making me think, you know, I should go back there, find it again, and start chucking bombs. Oh wait, this is one of those Yiga persons, isn't she? Yep, I remember this one. Got me a good one, but I got him several good ones, so we're all set. And I better heal. Oh yeah, I cooked an omelet. Check it out. Okay, I think that'll do for now. I can live with one heart missing. Oh yeah, did you notice, by the way, that these enemies now have numbers on their health meter? Yeah, that's... you might remember that. That's the function of having this shirt. Way. Might as well use their sickles. Up. Be careful. What was that? Oh, one of those guys. There's two of those guys. All right, if I sneak around this way, I might be able to come up from behind. Okay, that worked. What's this? A farming hoe. I know I saw another one over here. What, 13 out of 13? What's that? Two monsters? Uh-oh. that. Actually really bad. I want to get out of here. Is there an Octorok here? Yes, there is. Great. I am going to kill you. Where is this Octorok? There it is. Well, never mind. Well, that was harrowing. Now, I'm sure there was a sign up here that talked about another stable or something. What was that? Something shining on the ground. Oh, just one of these. And there I was all excited. What, ancient screw? What? Hey, you're probably wondering, is this the guy everyone's talking about? No, that's not what I was wondering. What I was wondering is, why did you say an ancient screw? I have a few of those. Might you give me something for it? Boy, you're really focused on yourself, aren't you? Nothing really comes to mind. Yeah, I know more about it than you do. There was a hidden shrine there that I revealed, and an invisible Korok that no one but me can see. Question for me, okay. Yeah, actually, I kinda do. Nah. Will you buy stuff? Let's see. Oh, I got a few more opals. Take them off my hands. And some of these. Oh yeah, diamond. On one of my most recent treasure hunts, I found this. 500 rupees. I'm keeping it though, because it's the only one I have, and I'm still convinced that they ought to be useful for crafting. Close to the sign so I can read it. Equestrian riding course. So So that would be that way. Okay. Oh, check out something I learned about these. Get close enough, they'll form up to drive you away. And if you hit them twice, they flee. And you can take their honey. Okay, I want to find out about this riding course. Is it another place where I can board my horses? That would be kind of useful. Looks like there's lots and lots of moblins around here. That's not so useful. I'm assuming these things are moblins. Okay, well, enough fooling around with this. Let's take a quick look at the map. Okay, so one of my destinations is immediately north. The question becomes, how do I get there? I suppose I could go back to Kakariko Village and go that way. Seems like quite a long detour, though. And again, I don't want to just leave my horse out here. That would be very irresponsible. Okay. Tell you what, viewers, I'm going to cut the video here, and then I will see you next time on Let's Play Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, when we meet back up in Kakariko Village. See you then!